Hey friends, so today we have a Sephora haul and I'm gonna try to go through it because this is not kind of a big one yet. It's kind of a big haul. These are things that I've purchased over probably like the past month. Yeah, I want to say the past month. These are some of my purchases, some things I got from Sephora, so I wanted to share them with y'all. I actually want to start with my favorite purchase. This was my birthday gift to myself here, and yes, let me show y'all. And I have a broken nail. Like, these are my natural nails with overlay, so I almost rarely break my nails. So I got this one broken, y'all, but I get it fixed in 2 days. My nail appointment is in 2 days. But yeah, if y'all see that broken nail, just ignore it. Just disregard that. This right here, I'm so excited about this purchase. I absolutely love Danessa Myricks, and I think I say that almost every video, probably almost every makeup video that I do, because almost on the daily I use her products. When I saw this palette, I just knew that I had to have it. Like, there were no questions. It was not up for discussion or debate. I knew I had to have it. And so I'm like, you know, let me like treat myself for my birthday. And it didn't help that I had a little case of the birthday blues. So, you know, little retail therapy never hurts. Sorry, I don't want to keep fixing my dress, but it's kind of big, so it like keeps sliding down. So sorry y'all, I know stuff like that be annoying. I'm sorry, I apologize. But here is the palette. This palette, it's revolutionary because of how the packaging and everything you can do with the packaging and whatnot. And it comes with these three separate palettes, and I'm just so excited about using this palette because of its innovation, because of the shades and like the different things that you can do with the palette. So I'm really excited to use it. I think I'm good on like colored palette because I have this palette. I have the Cosmos palette from Anastasia. I also got another palette. Now I got this other palette during the Sephora sale that was going on. So this palette was actually on sale, the next palette, not the Danessa Myricks child. Danessa wasn't on sale because this was a new launch, and this is actually limited edition. Now it is still available, but I didn't know if y'all were going to sell out the palette and buy them all up, and I wasn't going to be able to get me one. So I just knew that I had to act fast on that palette. Now this palette I purchased during the sale that Sephora was having a few weeks back. Would y'all believe me if I told y'all this palette was on sale for $18? I could not leave without purchasing this because that was just crazy. And I actually have like a few Too Faced eyeshadow palettes, and they're really good. This one smells like chocolate. Some shimmers, some mattes. I thought this was a really pretty palette, and this is the Too Faced Better Than Chocolate Cocoa Infused Eyeshadow Palette. Now, I've really been wanting the Hourglass concealers, and I actually went in store trying to find the concealers because I didn't know what shade I needed, so I swatched them. And I'm glad I went into the store and swatched them because initially I was going to get completely different shades because I was going based off of the shade recommendations of other people I thought who had a similar complexion to me. But when I went in and swatched them, I discovered that these two shades were better. First, I was about to get flax was too warm for my skin tone, and also it was a darker shade. It wasn't like the shade of my face. And so I got the shade Dune 7.5, and this is the shade that's going to work for me for like my skin tone shade. And then for my highlighting shade, I got the shade Beach, which is number 6. So I got two shades in the Hourglass concealer, and I've been hearing so many things about this concealer here. Either people love it adore it, swear by it, or people do not like it at all. So I'm like, I don't really know about that. Like, but I'm like, no, I really want to try it because I really love Hourglass products. Like, Hourglass has some really great products. So I'm like, let me go ahead and try the concealer and see what I think. And when I went into the store, I went into Sephora and I swatched it, and I swatched it like on my hand. I blended it out, and then I kind of like walked around for a bit to get a feel for it. And you know, I'm like, I think I might actually, you know, like this. So we're gonna see. We're gonna see what is given, what the Hourglass concealer is giving, because she's pricey. She's pricey and bougie. She's not cheap at all. So we're gonna see what she giving. And then I wanted to get another powder, and I'm just not convinced that I want to get the full size and the Charlotte Tilbury, the airbrush flawless finish powders, because I bought like the little mini size, and I believe the mini size is like $28 each. $28, I believe so, yeah. And then the full size is, I want to say, $48 each. That is a pretty penny, child. So I'm like, I don't know, like I use it and I don't know if I love it to buy the full size, especially buying the full size like not during a sale, maybe for like 20% off, 20-25% off, that's different. I might buy it for that full price, but not regular price, nah. So I decided to get this powder from Tower 28 here. And what is this, child? This is the Tower 28, the Get Set Blur and Set Press Powder. So this only comes in like a few shades. So the shade that I decided to get is the banana shade, and here it is here. And the banana shade is like a yellow tone, so this is supposed to like color correct. So I bought this to use in the highlighting portions of my face, like setting my highlighting concealer. This was much cheaper than the Charlotte Tilbury. Let me pull up my little Sephora app to see how much this one was, because yes, it definitely was much cheaper, which, let me see, Tower. Yes, so this powder is $28. So yeah, let's try that one out. Let's try that and see what we think. And then, y'all, these came back in stock at Sephora. This is the Velour Puff from the Sephora collection. These came back in stock. I set up the notifications to be text when these came back in stock, honey. So these are back in stock, so I picked up another one. This was during one of my Sephora hauls during the month, but I hadn't shown it in a video. So this is the Patrick Ta, the Major Skin Foundation, and I have it in shade 17, Golden Peach. Love this foundation. If I haven't already posted it, I will be posting a review, a thorough review of this foundation after I was able to do like a few wear tests and wear it different ways and figure out what works for me best for like applying this foundation. But I absolutely love this foundation, giving very much like flawless, beautiful, glowy skin. And then for what I'm wearing for my face today, I purchased the Huda Beauty Easy Blur Primer, and then the Huda Beauty, the Huda Beauty Easy Blur Foundation. The shade that I purchased in the foundation is 420G, which is Toffee. So that's what I'm wearing on my face today, and I've been wearing this for my complexion combo for over a week now, and I really, really have been enjoying this. And then I'm also wearing this from Huda Beauty, and this is the blush filter. I purchased this during one of my in-store trips to Sephora, and the shade is Strawberry Cream, and that's what I'm wearing on my cheeks for my blush today. And yes, I really love this. Such a pretty color, and it can be applied under and on top of powder without it like creating patchiness, emphasizing texture, or just pulling up whatever makeup. So yeah, I really like this. And lastly, I did purchase the latest launch from OneSize Beauty. Wait, which I had it upside down. This is the Turn Up the Base Full Beat Liquid Foundation, and I got it in the shade 35 Neutral Golden. So I hope that this shade works for me. When I put in a shade, my shade 17 for the Patrick Ta foundation in the shade finder on Sephora, it actually recommended that I get shade 10 Neutral Golden. I thought 10 Neutral Golden might be a little light for me, so I decided to get this one here, which is the 35 Neutral Golden. And this is in their medium dark shade range, and it does have a pump, so I'm excited to try this. I'm not really like a full beat girl, like, so I'm like but recently I went to a wedding, and to do my full beat for the wedding, I did a combination of the Danessa Myricks Yummy Skin Balm, and then I applied the House Labs foundation on top, and that gave me like that full beat look. So I'm like, okay, going out in certain events and stuff like that, I need a full beat foundation in my collection, because most of the foundations I have are either, if they're not skin tints, then they are medium covered. So I'm like, I need at least one full beat foundation for when I want to give it to them. So I'm like, I need at least one. So I got this one, and we're going to try it out. And I'm going to do a wear test, and I'm going to report back. And then I bought the sponge. They launched a sponge with this foundation. This is the OneSize Beauty Turn Up the Base Infinity Sponge. So I purchased the sponge as well. So I got y'all. I'm gonna do an application and wear test with this. So those were my recent Sephora pickups. Have y'all purchased anything from these new launches? I feel like I'm good on complexion products for right now, because it seems like it was like a complexion like era, like everybody was releasing new foundations, and then it was like all these new blush launches, and I'm like, I'm good on stuff right now. Like, I'm good on makeup. I said I'm going to be on a no buy until Black Friday when it comes to makeup, because I want to really just use the stuff that I've been buying and not be over consuming and hoarding. But it really be for like research purposes, y'all. I be want to try it out and then like let y'all know what I think about it. But right now I'm entering into my fashion era. So it's fall, and as we're in fall and approaching the winter, like I really want to get into my fashion era. So I'm going to be on like a makeup no buy, and then try to, you know, just add some new pieces to my fall and winter wardrobe. So let me know, have y'all bought anything from these new launches? Is it too much? They doing too much? They launching a new product every other day, child. Like, I'm tired, I can't keep up. But let me know, have y'all bought any of these things? If you have you tried them? Let me know what's tea, if they're good, down below in the comment section. And be sure to check back every day the month of October for new uploads, as I'm doing Vlogtober. So I'll be posting shorts or direct uploads to my YouTube channel, a new piece of content every day, from beauty to fashion to vlogs to lifestyle, everything in between. And yes, thank y'all for your support. You can check me out on TikTok and Instagram at iamgrowing.and.glowing. And I'll see y'all in my next video. Talk to you later. Bye.